So let's see, Sagittarius. Let's see what's coming your way when it comes to love. Oops. I know they are kind of slippery, but that's okay. We love the gold on them, don't we? So let's cut the cards and see the bottom of the deck for the overall energy at this time. The most important one, what we need to know. And we do have the Three of Pentacles and we do have the Sun, Leo energy, and the Page of Pentacles and the Strength and the Nine of Cups. So Sagittarius and the Strength again. You must be kidding me. You have Leo three times, Sagittarius. Maybe you have Leo in your chart, but this is about an offer of partnership. Page of Pentacles with the Three of Pentacles. Might be someone at work, might be someone you do business with, somebody in your environment, in the place you make money. And the Sun, they make you happy, you make them happy, and they show up twice. Strong, courageous, and we also have wish fulfillment, partnership, wish fulfillment, and an offer of love. Actually, it's an offer of happiness, right? We know the Sun is the ultimate happiness we can have with someone. And I would say happy partnership. Beautiful. So it might be somebody new, by the way. Somebody who finally gives their offer to you. So let's see. So recent past, we do have the Justice. We have the Five of Cups in reverse, Eight of Wands, and the Three of Swords. So we might have, anyways, Knight of Wands, here you are, in reverse a little bit, the High Priestess, the Four of Swords, and the Five of Swords. I know, we are coming out of probably a divorce, separation, something like that, or we've, you know, we've had this experience. We do have the Justice, and we know it's all about legalities, pieces of papers, and with the Three of Swords, you in reverse, it kind of feels like, you know, that was a hell of a fight. We have the Sun, maybe you have a child, you know, custody battles and all that kind of stuff. I feel though it happened, it's been a while now, and right now we are healing, bringing things back to balance. High Priestess, inner knowing, lessons between the dark and the light. So we are in between here, not quite out, but not no longer in, right? And the Four of Swords, planning and strategizing for the future. So, and the Justice in itself, it's a good energy of final decision. It's a good energy of wrapping up stuff and doing the right thing, making the right thing happen for you. Some I would say there was a legal battle with a legal mess, but it kind of reassures me, the High Priestess, because this is you seeing the bigger purpose in it, you seeing the spiritual path out of it, and probably a lot of rest. This was exhausting, right, Sagittarius? It has this energy of constant fight. You know, Five of Swords and the Five of Cups, changes, challenges, fights, emotions, overwhelming emotions, pain. So, you know, at some point, we had to do something about. So, Sagittarius, where are we right now? Eight of Cups. Definitely we keep going. I love this. Seven of Pentacles. Mm-hmm. Queen of Swords, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, and the Hangman in reverse. Sorry, guys, that's my phone. I know. Five of Pentacles in reverse. The Chariot, Cancer energy. Five of Wands. And the Seven of Wands. I know. We keep moving. I love this. We have Eight of Cups in the Chariot. Absolutely. We disconnected from something. We want to break free. This is Sagittarius, the energy of the Explorer, the Chariot, right? I feel you might have communication with this person from time to time. Five of Pentacles in reverse is like channels of communication are open. We have conversations from time to time. I have to defend myself. Five of Wands, I have to block and be a little bit on, you know, on your guard in some way. But you are doing the right thing. We have the Queen of Swords, and I'm pretty sure this is your energy, right? Seven of Pentacles, we are patient. We do the right thing. We do the communication that we need to, that's necessary. We unblock just the right amount. And we do have the Hangman in reverse. Why change your perspective when your purpose is to move on, right? And I kind of feel there is new love on the horizon, might be a Leo. This does look like, you know, like a new Page of Pentacles, right? Like a a renewed partnership, but let's not jump to conclusions. But I feel you so determined. I'm here to move on and break free from something that, you know, caused pain, kept you silent, kept you emotional, and uncomfortably emotional. Moving forward, speaking of new love, we do have the Ace of Cups. We do have the King of Pentacles in reverse, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Six of Swords upright, Two of Pentacles in reverse. Page of Cups. We have Page of Pentacles, Page of Cups, Ace of Cups. If this is new love, I wonder what this is. Nine of Pentacles in reverse, Justice again, Libra energy. You might have Libra in our chart and the Six of Swords, but I feel it's more about moving away from a situation. You have twice the Six of Swords as the outcome. Peace of mind, a little bit like Leo. Leo had a lot of inner peace in guidance and overall energy. And that is Leo all over this reading. So honestly, that is the outcome is just beautiful. Ace of Cups, Page of Cups, new love coming in. We have the King of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, you know. Might not be, you know, they might not be the most abundant people in the world, or maybe you have to make some effort, but commitment is good. And we have Justice and Six of Swords. For the fairness of it, for the God of it, for the love of it, right? Somebody needs peace of mind. From a troubling situation, some food for thought. If a chapter is not closed properly, right, and we embark in a new one, we just drag the baggage right into that commitment. And we have Two of Pentacles. Might be the King of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn that we need to drop. Two of Pentacles in reverse, and that's the outcome. We pretty much succeed, right? Sagittarius into dropping someone. And move away twice. It's like for your own good, let's drop this. Let's open up to love and new love is coming. So I am so not concerned. For the Sagittarius, I'm picking up the energy on. And energies of courage, of strength, energies of lust, energies of happiness, energies of wish fulfillment. So you name it. What do we have? The silver waterfall. The guidance is simple. We need to be transparent. We need to be self-protective, right? Behind the curtains, behind the waterfall, but yet transparent. And speaking of self-protection, the gardener. So this is where you are guided to protect your inner world, your inner child, whatever you work on. This is you taking care of you. And we have turn on your heart light, Sagittarius. Reflect on a time when you experienced love. Kind of like the universe, right? Asking you to open up to love while being very cautious about. And we have self-respect. That is something, right, that we need to work on. That is something that we need to put on the forefront. And look at this new love. Embrace an opportunity for love in your work prospects and for spiritual growth. I do feel you are guided towards new love no matter what, Sagittarius. Twice the Justice is, that's it. That's my final countdown, right? So let's have the energies we need to put back into the phone. It's interesting, self-respect, self-esteem. So there is a Sagittarius out there that really needs to look into. I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and others. Purpose. I know what I'm here to do, right? So you are guided to identify what is your purpose. What makes you happy? What makes you confident? Releasing doubt. I release the need to know all the answers. And individuality, self-respect and individuality. You leave your unique stamp of love on everything you do, and bottom of the deck, surrender to rest and sleep. So somebody needs a good night's sleep, I guess. Somebody really needs to rest and be at peace and know that new love is coming, that is no doubt. And even the Justice, right? The fairness, the karma, it brings a sense of release and a sense of rest is finally over, right? So Sagittarius, this is all that I have for you guys, and I love you. I wish you nothing but the best. I wanted to stay strong and safe, and come see me next time. Love you. Take care. Bye.